It's Kelly here, and today I'll be doing a first ASMR video. What do you freaking do? It's basically gonna be playing a bit of Overwatch, because basically who doesn't love playing their favorite, well, watching their favorite games? Basically. So after adjusting my headset, I'll be playing Tracer for this first round. It's competitive, so I'll probably end up playing a healer on defense, because that's usually how it goes. But so it's currently the winter event, and yesterday I got the winter skin, which is really nice. I really like it, because Ross, my friend, got it the day before, and he was teasing me, let's put it that way, about him having it and me not, when he doesn't play Tracer, and I probably bum out Tracer. So I got it yesterday and I was very pleased, because basically, you know, now I've got the Christmas skin for a operator, which I actually use. A hero, should I say. Operator. Rainbow Six Siege Vernacular. I've been playing some Overwatch recently, because it's Christmas holidays. So, basically, past couple of days has been Siege and Overwatch. And I'll probably be doing some Siege gaming videos as well. But for now, I'll keep it Overwatch. So, we're contesting the point right now. Got some resistance. Like this soldier. There we go. Oh, just missed that Roadhog hook. And then we stuck the Roadhog. That was decent. Sticky bomb there. Because we just took out a tank all by ourselves, basically. And then I nearly get destroyed by a Junkrat. Their Mercy's doing well, actually. There we go. I always think D.Va's ultimate is friendly, when it's just not. So I should really learn to just run away anyway, but I just don't. So, we've got a bit of a guy in chat. That's pretty funny. I'll disconnect from speech when I next die. Sweet. Because sort of a bit distracting, in it. I'll just quickly go in here and do that. Hopefully you get some decent clicky sounds. Although I wouldn't expect too decent, seeing as it's not a proper mechanical clicky keyboard. It's just a membrane one from Alienware that came with my PC. I've just used it ever since, essentially. Just got taken out by a Soldier 76 Ultimate, which is a bit annoying, but I just completely ignored the fact that I heard him say, "I've got you in my sights," so it's definitely my fault that I died there. Oh my god, all the alts now. Farrer up top. Just stuck the Roadhog, and now they're gonna take out whatever resistance is left. Oh, I hate Junkrat. Playing as Tracer against Junkrat is so annoying, because he can just kill you so quickly. There we go. So we won the first. completed my placements yesterday, and this is a control point, so no healers. Yeah, I completed my placements yesterday and got put in gold. Although I don't know which gold it is, and I don't really care because I don't play for ranks in games. Maybe I'll talk about it sometime, but CSGO put me off playing for ranks forever, basically. So now it's all about just playing for fun. That's the only reason I play ranked. Just playing ranked because it's more fun than casual, which it is. Especially in a war, my god. Especially in games like Siege, where casual is... where ranked just gives you a lot more functionality. A lot more options, basically, compared to, what is it, like, casual, basically, so. Plus, the longer game's just nicer, because you get more of a build-up through it, and you can sort of settle in with your team and with your map, rather than constantly having to sort of reset mentally with every game change, because the games are so short in casual. See, this is why I hate Junkrat. Just took down most of my health with what, like one shot. I also hate Rodog. It's just those two against Tracer. It's just horrific. I try to sort of blink out the way of Rodog's hook and Junkrat's grenade pellets. Oh, didn't do it that time. Both got in the way. But yeah, they're just extremely annoying to fight against as Tracer, just because of how they can. Obviously, Rodog with his hook, how that just completely destroys your mobility. And then, Junkrat with his high damage output is just really annoying. See, like that, I just can't. This is actually quite a bad game for me as Tracer. I really haven't done that much damage. Kind of feeling not that useful right now. But, someone put in chat, can someone handle Reaper? Oh dear. Oh dear. That's alright then. Take out them. Sorry, not sorry. Oh my god, we can just recall back that health. That's one of my favourite things to do as Tracer, is to just recall health. Because, it just feels good, basically. Someone's took you down like most of the way. It's funny. Not sure what this actually sounds like, but oh crikey. That was a bad blink. Speaking of bad. So we managed to recall out the way of his hook. Basically lost a 6 second window after that. So he's probably got it back up. Yeah, and he's looking to use it. Blinked out the way of that one as well. So fingers crossed if he doesn't grab a health pack, which he just has, and he's healed up. Oh, I was hoping. Oh, go on. Okay, it was stuck. What was happening there after I got hooked was I was hoping that I'd somehow get out of it, and then he would have brought me in close to him, so then I'd be able to just basically pulse bomb him then and there. But obviously, he did kill me, because there's a very slim chance that he wasn't going to kill me, because all he has to do is hit left click, so, you know, but, so we're back up with this control point team fight, and there we go. Hopefully we can get on this Anna. There we go, took down the Anna. Rodog. Junkrat, sorry. A couple more. Just trying to do some damage before they come out of spawn, or at least come into view of the rest of the team. Grab a bit of health. No! Okay. My god, that was close. So we nearly fell down the hole in the middle of Ilios, capture point B. So that would have ended badly, but it's fine. Junkrat's actually just died. it's just ice cubed on site. I just got pushed down the hole, but it's fine. I recalled out of it. There we go. Stuck a pulse bomb onto Lucio. And that took him out and took down nearly all of D.Va's mech's health. Which is fine. This Rotog is... not Rotog, sorry. I keep calling Rotog Junkrat. I keep calling Junkrat Rotog, sorry. I love it when she says that. Tracer basically just said, dashing through the snow. And I absolutely love it when she says that, because it's such a cute little thing. I just love Tracer, to be honest. That's just the deal. Okay. Try to blink backwards and the wall just blocked me in, basically. There we go. So we just won round two. So, that was a decent comeback on the control point. Because they got to 99, I think, or 98. And then we brought it back, and then basically won in a clear sweep, and kind of spawn trapped them. I don't want to say we did, because, you know, that's not a great thing to do, but, you know, whatever you have to do to win, and it's still within the rules, and you can use it to win, so why not? So now we're on the third control point on Ilios. Where it's sort of the covered one. It's the covered one by the edge of the cliff. I'm not that sure how to better describe it. So we're gonna sort of blink across from this side. Because that was just a waste of time and blink. But their mei is gonna be a bit of a pest on this control point just because of. And their Rodok's also gonna be a bit of a pest. But this control point, I always find it's quite annoying to fight against Maze Tracer on this one, just because when you're on the control point, it's not the easiest one to blink around on, and that's basically your main asset against someone like Mei, is your ability to blink around. But just because the sort of enclosing walls that are around the objective, which you often get caught on while blinking, that just takes away a lot of your mobility. So, like I was saying before I went into that horrible long explanation, Mei is going to be difficult to fight against here, which is fine. You know, wouldn't play games without challenge. That's what I tell myself when I'm crying because I've deranked or something. I don't cry because I've deranked. Oh my god, damn it. I'm just about to recall out of that, and then we get shotgun from the side by Rotog. So we've got a pulse bomb up, which basically means that we're gonna stick this to someone on the control point and hopefully get one or two kills here. Because they've got a D.Va and a Mei and a Rotog, and that was terrible. It's got a hit marker. Okay. Rotog's done his hook. Okay. See, we're just gonna stand behind this cut sort of cover. No! We got pushed off by Lucio. Ah. Oh, that was decent, Lucio. I'm gonna move the mic slightly. There we go. So, we've respawned. I moved the mic slightly further back. So, hopefully that changes something. Okay then. I guess we'll go this way. Oh, there's a Mei. See, I can blink about a bit here. Which is basically my main advantage in a 1v1 against Mei as Trace. Just keeping that mobility so she can't freeze me. And she decided to break off and engage someone else. To move on to the control point, basically. And that was, so I think me blinking around basically made her give up on trying to freeze me and get the kill, because she just went onto the objective. Gonna move the mic a little bit higher. There we go. So this is a 222 setup. Ross, my friend who got the tracer skin I was talking about earlier, the day before I did, he always talks about the 222 setup apparently being the meta. I don't know whether that is the meta. I don't know what the meta is, to be honest, of Overwatch right now, what the sort of team comp meta, but I'm not really too that deep into Overwatch. I just play it. I just pick someone I like and go and shoot stuff with it. But, you know, Maze Ice Cube. Get right up close and just... Oh, that was well played. That's a decent escape by May there. Hopefully the clicking sounds aren't too intense. Just because of how much I'm trying to move about right now, just to keep mobile.
Junkrat. Or for me to hate Junkrat, I don't know. Maybe you like Junkrat.
tried it. But, you know. Yeah. Our Zenyatta is decent, so we'll give him a little plus. So, that was the game, basically. That's game over. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully this has helped you relax, or get tingles, or go to bed, or go to sleep, or just to watch, to be honest. So, thank you so much for watching. I've been Kelly, and I don't know, I haven't worked out an ending for these videos. Should it fade out, or what? Or just cut? I don't know. We're sort of awkwardly sitting on the menu. Let's watch a highlight. Hang on. Let's watch a highlight, and then I'll leave you. It's not going to be that good, because I don't remember any standout moments, to be honest, but whatever. Gotta love that skin. I love how she, blows her fringe out the way, even though she doesn't have a fringe in the way. I just think that's a bit funny. Oh, that's where I stick the... Oh, okay. That wasn't too bad. Managed to kill my arch nemesis, so... That's not too bad. Thank you so much for watching. I've been Kelly. This has been Overwatch competitive game with Tracer. Only Tracer. Wow, that was a good game. And thank you so much for watching. And I'll make some more videos, I suppose.